Hi, my name is Peter Zalewski. I'm the founder of CraneSpotters.com. CraneSpotters is a pre-construction condo project website that focuses on new developments since 2011 that are being built east of I-95 in Miami-Dade, Broward, Palm Beach counties. In 2015, we're doing weekly updates of various markets to give you, the viewer, some kind of idea of what's happening on a real-time basis in the marketplace here in South Florida from a condo perspective. So for the week of February the 23rd, 2015, we're going to be focusing on Greater Downtown Miami. Now, in our previous segment about Greater Downtown Miami earlier this year, we took a look at what was going on in the resales, the rentals, as well as the pre-construction. For this particular segment, I want to focus more so on the pre-construction. I will tell you, in looking at the first 2 months of data, and it's not yet final, it'll probably be finalized, I'd say, in the next 15 to, call it, definitely 30 days, but probably about 15 days. It looks as if inventory is increasing. Transactions are falling, both on a rental basis as well as a resale basis in Greater Downtown Miami. And rents are still going up, but they're not going up at the same pace they were in previous years. So I don't expect to to see some sort of leveling off of the marketplace as the final data starts to come out in 2015. At least in Greater Downtown Miami, that's what's being suggested. Now let's talk a little bit about Greater Downtown Miami. The reason we're focusing on it is this week we're doing our tour of Greater Downtown Miami. We're gonna put people on a bus, we're gonna drive them around for 3 hours, we're gonna show them 72 new towers that are going up in the 60 block stretch. Those 70 new towers, they're representing about 19,600 condos. How does that compare to last go around? Well, our last boom from 2003 to 2010, there were about 84 towers created, and those 84 towers represented about 22,200 units. So it looks as if things keep going as they are, we should match, if not surpass, the number of units at least announced as which were created during the last go around in that cycle. Now, to give you an idea of our current cycle and where we're at, let me sort of tell you where the condos are in the pipeline. And the way we define the pipeline is basically four categories. One is proposed, meaning a developer wants to build but does not yet have municipality approval to do so. So that's proposed. Then the next is planned. Planned is a developer wants to build and has municipality approval to do so. Third phase is under construction, and the fourth phase is going to be completed. So currently today, of the 19,600 condos that have been announced for Greater Downtown Miami, we're finding about 28% of them are proposed. Again, meaning someone wants to build, but they don't have approval to do so. We have another 36% where the developer wants to build and has approval to do so. And then if you look at under construction, it represents about 31%, and 6% of all the towers, of all the units that have been announced thus far are currently completed and been delivered. For what it's worth, in the last 2 weeks, that we just had a closing at a project called the 1100 Millicento Residences. This one is located on South Miami Avenue, just under 400 units or so, about 43 stories. It's just come to market, it's just begun its closing. The closings are being recorded, at least initially, just under $500 a square foot. So I think the developer of that is gonna be happy, that as well as the buyers in that particular marketplace. Now, going out a little bit further and looking at the data in Greater Downtown Miami, I want to tell you a little bit about what we do monthly, and that is a developer price survey. So every month we're calling up the various developers and or the brokers, and we're asking what's the pricing at your office currently? So we ask about minimum pricing, we also ask about maintenance, we ask about commissions, if you're a realtor and you care. So here's a summary of Greater Downtown Miami based on our February 2015 survey. Currently in Greater Downtown Miami today, the minimum buy-in price for the worst unit across the board in all the projects that are currently selling, and the number of projects currently selling, is coming in at about 38 towers and roughly under 11,100 units. About 11,100 units are currently being sold pre-construction in Greater Downtown Miami. Now, when we look at the minimum price, it's coming in at $542 a foot. So $542 a foot you should expect to pay on a minimum basis to come into a brand new condo tower in Greater Downtown Miami today. Now, when you pay that $542 a foot and you agree to do so, you should know that the average maintenance fee per month you're gonna be paying per square foot is gonna be about 65 cents a square foot per month. If you look at what the pre-sale ratio is of all these condos that are currently available for sale, about 68% of them have been pre-sold. So chances are, if you walk into a pre-sale office today, overall, about 2 out of every 3 units would have already been sold. Again, this is a survey, this is information coming from in-house people for the developer, him or herself, and or their brokers. And then if you are a realtor and you care, the commission being paid in Greater Downtown Miami on average is about 6%. It's about 6%. Anybody playing at home and wants to know what's the highest priced condo currently, from a minimum price perspective, what's the highest priced project today currently in Greater Downtown Miami? It's gonna be the 1000 Museum Tower, which is designed by Zaha Hadid. That's the project that's going up on what used to be known as the most expensive gas station in Miami. whatever a gallon of gas would trade for or would sell for, this gas station right there on Biscayne Boulevard across from the new Museum Park, they were always about $1 a gallon more than anywhere else because they were effectively the only gas station around. So that project, 1000 Museum, is the most expensive minimum price per square foot of any projects in all of Greater Downtown Miami. It's coming in at just about $1,200 a foot. The next second most expensive is going to be the Echo Brickell. Echo Brickell is going up at 15th Road and Brickell Avenue, right in the shadow of the Four Seasons on the south side of Brickell Avenue. You want to know what the cheapest price is per square foot for a project. Minimum price per square foot for a project. It's coming in as a Crystal Tower. If you don't know where the Crystal Tower is, it's just west of where the new $2 billion Miami World Center is slated to go up. Crystal Tower comes in at just under $350 a foot. So that is a perspective about what's going on in Greater Downtown Miami today. We're going to check back with you probably in about a month or so. We'll give you another update about Greater Downtown Miami. But if you do have any questions about pre-construction or resales or any of that type of stuff, I would suggest you check out our website, cranespotters.com with an S, and or give us a telephone call, 305-865-5859. This is Peter Zalewski from the Edgewater area of Greater Downtown Miami, and I'll be speaking to you again, or speaking with you again, next week. Thank you.